Hello there, my name is Ariel Benari. I'm a product manager at Qualy, and today I'd like to talk to you about testing complex multi-tier applications in production-like environments that include all of the software components and all of the network connectivity requirements. How is this being done today? So either we do it in the lazy way out, which means taking a single component or all of the components and testing them, but usually with a single network, okay? That's not the way our software is gonna work in production, and that's the problem, that this testing is not really simulating what we're gonna face when we reach production. The other way we can do it, this is the tedious way, managing a set of scripts or definitions of defining all of the network definitions and requirements, but these files need to be updated all the time because the product evolves and my applications change. So that's pretty much tedious because I have to go all the time and change them. So what is the Qualy solution for this problem? Qualy defines dynamic test environments, which we call blueprints, and we allow you to model all of the software components and the network elements that you want to have in your environment. So let's take a simple example where we have two web servers and a load balancer that we'd like to have being connected to each other under one network, let's call it the web network. We have two application servers that we want to have connected to an application network, and two databases that we want to have in their own network, okay? So you go ahead and model them using a visual tool. We support all of the popular clouds, both public and private, but for the sake of this demonstration, let's use AWS, okay? Once I've added all of the components I need to my blueprint, I go ahead and I make the necessary network configurations, which include the access level, meaning public or private network, the size of the network that I'd like, meaning how many IP addresses I'd like to add to these networks, and define the security definitions, which ports and which instances are available to communication from other ports in the environment. Once I've done all of this, I can go ahead and deploy the blueprint, actually creating a live environment, which we call a sandbox. In the case of AWS, what we do when this environment is spun up, we create a VPC to isolate all of the components in a single envelope. We create the subnets that we defined in the blueprint. We create the instances, connect the instances to the networks that we've modeled, power on the machines, and then run post-deployment configuration, whether scripts or Ansible playbook and such. Once this environment is live, you can interact with the instances. It's a live environment, you can use it. And I also like to mention that the orchestration or the setup of this environment is actually customizable. So you can write your own code and do your own stuff when this environment is created. Once we're done using the environment, we terminate it. And in the turnup process, we actually destroy everything that we've created. And as a result, you just pay for the time that you've used the environment. That's all for today. I hope it was interesting. And if you'd like to learn more, please visit us at www.qualy.com. Thank you very much.